guys, this is Fia from Fia's Handmade Soaps, and I am back with a video to cut my sherbet soap. So it's been in the mold for 2 days. I forgot to put it in the freezer before I did this, so my son just took a nap. So I'm like, oh, I can't wait for the cut, so whatever. I'm just gonna go ahead and take it out the mold without putting it in the freezer and hope it doesn't stick too much to the sides. Try and get this out as gently as possible. But this mold from Nurture Soap is absolutely perfect. The soap comes out so perfect. To see what the inside looks like. I'm trying not to smoosh up the sides, but you know me. I probably smooshed up at least one of the sides. I should have put my gloves on so I didn't get any soap sticking to my hands, which I probably need to do now. 1 second, let me get my gloves. So, this soap is scented in Cucumber Melon Bath and Body Works type. It smells just like the Bath and Body Works scent. It really does. Just like it. And if you recall, I sprinkled some glitter on top, some pink and regular silver glitter. Not a lot. Just enough to give it a little sparkle. Got my handy modified cheese cutter here. To cut my soaps in 1-inch pieces. And here we go. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, that is perfect. Look at that. That is perfect. The only thing not perfect is drag marks from the wire. But that is perfect. Oh my god. Wow. Move my tripod bag. Start running these soaps up on the side. That is so perfect. Look at that. Wow. Definitely calling this soap sherbet. Definitely. Sherbet! It looks just like it. You know those sherbet buckets that your parents used to buy back in the day. I guess they still sell it. I'm not sure. Those big clear buckets that you would get at the grocery store. And it just said sherbet on it. But they were also good. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. I can't believe how pretty this is. I honestly can't believe how pretty this is. Turn it around. Oh my goodness. Wow. That's definitely a wow. Didn't mean to make so much noise with that, because don't want baby to wake up screaming, mommy, mommy, mommy. When I'm trying to cut my soap. this one. Wow. Scented in cucumber melon. Bath and Body Works type. Yes. Absolutely perfect design for perfect fragrance. Wow. That's absolutely beautiful. I can't believe how great it turned out. All from an in-the-pot swirl. If you go back and watch my video, how I got these swirls is I pretty much put color in. It was a, you know, doing hot process, one big old pot, and I just put color in three different parts of the pot, stirring each part to stir into color in that little section. What I didn't do was mix it all together because I didn't want to be muddied. So those three different colored sections, all I did was when I ladled it out of the pot and put it into the mold, I just made sure I had all three colors on each spoon and just put it into the mold in no particular pattern or anything to get my swirl look. And it came out absolutely perfect. Absolutely. And that's how I will always do my swirls from now on. I've never gotten such great swirls during cold process. But these swirls on high process is definitely amazing. The easiest swirls you could ever do. Came out perfect. Ooh, look at that one. That one got more green in it. I used green, orange, and pink. Two of the colors are from Nurture Soap, actually. The orange, I think it's like Orange Vibrance and Pink Lemonade. And the green is, I got it from a stash group that people, someone was selling because they were moving or something. And they were selling all of their soap supplies. But it has like a rainbow icon on the package and it just says green. So. Boy, is these colors perfect. Had to wait two agonizing days to cut this soap to see what the heck it looked like because I just couldn't wait. It smelled so good, I just couldn't wait, but I did. And I'm glad I waited. Oh, yeah. Oh, and I used titanium dioxide for the bright, the white color. It's not really white, but as I was cooking the soap, in the beginning, I didn't use any milk or anything. It just seemed like it was getting a little too tannish brown for me. And I knew I wanted to use bright colors. So I said, you know what, let me just put a little titanium dioxide in there and just brighten it up a little bit. Of course, it wasn't going to get white. I didn't expect it to get white. Just, I didn't want it to look brownish because the bright colors, I wanted to come out. I didn't want it to look all, you know, dark or anything. So I decided to use some titanium dioxide. And how I added that was after I had reached trace when I was stick blending my soap, I just scooped some out into another container, poured a couple, what did I use? Maybe like one or two, maybe a tablespoon of titanium dioxide, and I just stick blended it into that cup of soap. And then when that was done, I just poured it back into the pot. It didn't make the soup extremely white or anything, but it did look really white at first, and then as the cook started to come on, it started to, you know, mellow out and look a little more the neutral white color that I was looking for, like an off-white or light cream color, you know. Absolutely perfect. guys can really see the shimmer of glitter on top. But this is definitely a perfect bar soap.
And it smells so good. It smells just like Bath & Body Works Cucumber Melon.
Exactly. Like, really crazy. My friend Lisa is obsessed with cucumber melon everything. So I said that I would make her some soap. Now at the time, when, because I'm in a fragrance pre-buy group, and at the time where we was doing the pre-buy for cucumber melon, I passed it up because, you know, I was like, first of all, I didn't remember that actually Bath & Body Works had a cucumber melon because it's been years since I actually used a cucumber melon, you know, let alone been in Bath & Body Works for a while. And so I passed it up. I was like, yeah, I'm not sure I want a soap that smells like that. Not really remembering what it smells like. And once the pre-buy was over, you know, the guy who runs the group, Pat Dubois, he, you know, he has to wait for the fragrances to come from his supplier so he can ship it to the people who, in the group who ordered it. So by that time, when, my friend Lisa said, oh, I love cucumber melon, you should make me some cucumber melon soap. And I was like, pre-buy is over. And then something happened and then it was the manufacturer. No, he received the package, but I guess the delivery people, the USPS or whoever, they damaged it, so he had to wait for the manufacturers to send him new bottles of cucumber melon. So I'm like, where the heck am I going to get cucumber melon from now? And of course, I'm in like 4D stash groups and somebody was selling it, so I just got it from them. And I think my baby is awake. Yep, he's crying. He's with daddy though. Unfortunately, he likes to nap mostly with mama. So hopefully daddy can get him under wraps so I don't have to stop my video to go grab him and put him back to sleep. That is beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. I absolutely love this. I love it so much. Oh, I just did that. Just holding it. I love this. This is so awesome. So awesome. My goodness. Wow. I'm not sure who sells, like, for one of our soap suppliers, who sells cucumber melon fragrance? I think, actually, I think Nurture Soap actually sells cucumber melon. Yeah, they do. So if you were looking for a supplier who sells this fragrance, or you can just join my fragrance group on Facebook called Savvy IntelliSense Fragrances, and I'll put the link below. And you know, he has cucumber melon pre-buy. It came in, he's shipping them out, and everybody who missed the first pre-buy will probably be ordering off his site now. Because I'm definitely going to need some more of this. Definitely. I've forgotten how good it smells. Because you know, as you get older, you get out of a lot of those fragrances that you used when you were a teenager, and you look for more perfumey or perfume fragrances. But I just haven't really been in Bath & Body Works in a really long time.
That's super pretty. Yeah, I haven't been there in a really long time, so I don't know what they got. Well, it's holiday season now, so they probably got a bunch of stinking holiday stuff. Like, stinking stuff like anything with pine in it. Smelling pine and, ugh, and eucalyptus, ugh, it stinks. I don't really like holiday scents. If it ain't pumpkin, I don't really like it. My favorite Bath and Body Works scent was Warm Vanilla Sugar. I think that's what it was called back when I was actually shopping there. And Japanese Cherry Blossom? I think that's what it was called. Those usually the only the two that I would buy from there. It just seemed like everything I smelled in here didn't smell good to me. Besides those two. That's so pretty. Sherbert all the way. Definitely. I keep hitting the tripod. Don't forget to check out my page on Facebook, guys, under Fia's Handmade Soaps. Soaps with an S, not, you know, not just soap. Soaps. I just like the S on the end of soap. I know people was probably wondering, like, why did she say soaps? I just like to say soaps. Just hit the edge, trying to hit the edge on a mold piece here. Yeah, stupid mold in the way. Made me. I can put it back in shape. I can do it. Because the soap is still soft. Took baby upstairs. Probably so he wouldn't mess up my video. But he wouldn't mess up my video. That's my baby. He's definitely a crybaby. Definitely. That boy cries for absolutely any and everything. He's two. And this cucumber melon got the whole house smelling like cucumber melon. The whole house. When I was making it, my husband was saying that it was giving him a headache. Because I guess it was so strong when I was making it and when the soap was hot. And I don't know, I guess from the soap being hot and then adding fragrance, it was just too much. He was like, what is that? But after I was done making it, and I had it in the mold and just set it to the side. He was like, okay, now it smells good. But I guess the fact that, I don't know. Maybe it's because everything was hot and it did something, I don't know, with the fragrance. But he likes it now. But when I was making the soap and I added the fragrance, he didn't. Almost done. I said this channel is going to be what, cold process, high process, and rebatch. So far I haven't rebatched anything, and so far I probably did like maybe two cold process videos, and the rest has been high process. I'm just, you know, high process, I'm just better at it. I'm just not really good at cold process. Not good as far as like, I know how to do it, it's easy, but doing designs and swirls and stuff like this, I couldn't get this doing cold process. Every time I've tried to do some type of swirl or something, it has been a disaster. It would get thick on me and
I would wind up just plopping the colors on top, and I'm just like, why do I even bother with this? I think I tried to do, in one of the videos, the quote process was Rose Garden. I was trying to do a specific design, and it did not turn out the way I wanted because it got really, really thick, and I couldn't really do anything with it but plop it on top and try and do a hanger swirl. And I still don't like that soap. I wanted to rebatch. I still might. I don't know. But people seem to sort of like it. We'll see. Or instead of rebatching, I was thinking about just cutting it up and giving it as samples or something. If I don't know. But this one is definitely going on sale. This is beautiful. This is an absolute beautiful soap. Professional cutter, so I won't be trying to, you know, line everything up, or because this thing, even though you would think, but it still wobbles. And I have a marker here showing where my 1-inch mark is, but this piece here is a little crooked, so you can't really lay the soap up against it and get a straight cut. You gotta kind of, I just, you know, I really need that cutter. I'm gonna get it. It's just gonna take a minute because I am fed up with these wonky cuts. They don't be too bad, barely even noticeable, but the person who's cutting the soap always notices. Other people might not really notice too much, but I do. I notice. This is perfect. And it's high process, so you see all the top looks a little wonky, but that lets you know it's a hot process soap. There's nothing wrong with it looking like that. It's handmade, homemade, however you want to say it. And a lot of people like it like that. I like it like that. Okay, here's the end piece that will get sliced in probably 4 samples. End piece is pretty. The bag is just pink. I'll slice this piece for samples. Do I want to slice it in half? I think so, why not? Only 2 samples. That's cool. I say samples when I probably really mean they're going to be in my bathroom or in the kitchen. It'll probably just be for me. Definitely been an awesome soap, and thank you guys for staying with me again, watching me do another soap. I hope you guys are, you know, learning from anything I do. You can always ask me any questions or, you know, comment below. I'll answer anything. So thank you guys again, and I'll see you for the next soap.